Stacking minions can be hard as Nasus top lane when you are against an early game dominant matchup, and getting kills can be even harder. So a lot of time passes until you can get finally useful. But there is one place where all these kind of things can be avoided. The jungle. A place where you can freely collect stacks without being afraid of getting killed by an enemy laner.
Hello there.
Well, at least most of the time you can collect stacks without being interrupted. Unlike minions, the big jungle monsters give you 12 stacks, which is the same amount you get when you kill an enemy with your Q spell. And with the summoner spell Ghost and his point and click slow, Nasus jungle has one of the easiest ganks set up in this game without actually being a jungler. So how does a gank of Nasus look like? Run, slow, and bonk them to death with the Q spell in order to collect 12 Q stacks. So you are not only being effective during the early game by helping your teammates with ganks, since at the same time you are scaling to infinity. Here are the build and runes, and now I will show you how to gain so much stacks in a few minutes that you can delete an enemy with one Q bonk. Or maybe two. Anyway, let's talk about his clear path. Nasus jungle is going to start his jungle clear at the blue buff. Why? Because the lack of AoE damage makes the red side clear significantly harder. Well, we have talked enough, now it's finally time to clear this thing. But watch out, don't use your Q spell instantly, but rather start with an auto attack and use your Q as an auto attack reset. And just repeat this process every time when the Q spell is up again. Just make sure to kill the monster with your bonk ability, since this is the only way to gain stacks. When you are not used to play Nasus and can't calculate his Q damage, you end up with jungle monsters that have 10 HP left.
No stacks for you.
And since they all have a different max amount of HP, it's really hard to calculate when exactly you should use your Q to execute them.
Nope.
Anyway, the next camp you are going to clear with your E spell equipped is the Gromp.
My name is Giovanni Giorgio, but everybody calls me Giorgio.
Throw your circle on that thing and reduce its resistances. That way you deal more damage with your autos and the Q ability. To the auto attack reset thing and finish the frog with the bonk spell. At the wolves you are doing the same preacher as on the last camp. Here comes the handy part about the circle, since it allows you to clear camps with multiple monsters faster thanks to its AoE damage. Make sure to kill the big one with your Q spell, since that's the target that will grant you 12 stacks. The other two are worthless since they give you the same amount stacks as a caster minion. But they will make sure that Nasus will hit level 3 and put the third skill point into the W spell. Which might sound weird at the first moment, since Nasus' main goal is to collect stacks and reach level 6 as fast as possible. Wouldn't it be smarter to put a second point into the Q ability in order to increase the clear speed, which results into a faster level 6? More stacks and more gold for his first power spike item, Divine Sunderer. While there is a reason for this decision, which I will explain later. Repeat the clearing process at the raptors and the red buff and skip the golems and move directly towards the scuttlecrab. Sometime it might happen that you have to fight for this thing against the enemy jungler. Now the W spell comes in very handy, since it's not just a point and click slow, but also has the benefit that it debuffs the enemy into the ground. 35.25% cripple effect, which basically reduces the enemy's attack speed. To be honest, this effect won't help that much, since the enemy is probably too busy running away. So when you manage to find a teammate that helps you during the fight, you're good. But when there is no one who wants to help you, well, you might get into some trouble, since Nasus early game sucks. Most of the time give this crab up and move on towards the other one, or try to gank a lane. When it comes to this part of Nasus jungle kit, which is just as brain dead as the jungle clear part, since there are just a few things you need to consider. Checking if the enemy laner is overextending. Walk to that lane and slow the enemy champion by just clicking on him. Throw the circle on your opponent and deal some damage with auto attacks and Q spell. Well, especially try to kill them with your Q spell in order to get 12 stacks. And that's how to gank a lane with Nasus jungle. If you really want to make sure to get the kill, just activate Ghost and run your opponent down. I mean, how is he going to prevent me doing so? He can run as fast as he can. I'm going to slow you anyway and collect my 12 stacks. Since you don't have any kind of dashes or other gank abilities, the only thing Nasus can do is walk towards the enemy. Oh, I got stunned, but since I managed to slow the Jhin, it doesn't really matter, since he can't escape anyway. Just auto attack a few times and secure the kill with your Q spell.
No. Man, I'm gonna break my monitor, I swear!
But when your laner doesn't die before you come to the lane, it gets easier to secure the kill due to the fact that Nasus has a lack of damage during the early state of the game. So when you are with two people, the gank is definitely going to succeed. And when you really want to make sure to get the kill, use Ghost and Smite and run them down. Counterplay.
No.
But since you spent so much time walking around, Nasus might get tired and you have to give him some rest. In that case, just wait inside a bush so instead of running toward the opponent, they will now come towards you. Let's have a fair fight. I mean, some additional stacks has never hurt anyone. Except your opponent. But this is the part of the game where Nasus is actually quite weak. He isn't really tanky and the Q damage is ridiculous because of the lack of items and stacks. So when you run into the enemy jungler by accident, the chance of winning the confrontation is quite low. Maybe the start of the fight looks kinda solid, but once when your spells are on cooldown, you don't really do much besides existing. That's why Nasus should manage to hit level 6 as fast as possible. And there is just one way to achieve this. Farm, farm, farm. From now on, Nasus gets way stronger and he get all his buffs and debuffs for the enemy by just pressing the ult button. You think you are going to fight? Just get bigger and do the same things you did before level 6. Because the only thing that will change is your damage and your sustain. Oh no, wait. It also increases your auto attack range and reduces the cooldown of your Q spell. And since the range of the Q ability is equal to your auto attack range, you can spam your high damage bunk spell even more. Additionally to that, ganking lanes gets even more safer, since when you think the situation is getting a bit out of hand, just press the R button and you should be fine. Now there are two options. You keep fighting in the hope that you get some kills. Or execute plan B, which consists of running away. But not only ganking lanes, but even tower diving gets viable with Nasus after unlocking the ultimate. Press R and dive straight into it. Oh crap, that hurts a little bit too much, let me get out of this area. Oh, what a coincidence. I was just looking for 300 gold. So you think you can get away with this?
Oh, fuck.
You have already wasted enough of my time. Just die.
Nope.
Finally, she died after 1 minute running around. Well, from now on, this game gets easier from minute to minute, since by just farming the jungle camps with Nasus Q spell, you keep scaling at the same time. Your damage increases, your slow gets stronger, and Nasus gets harder to kill, which gives him more time and chances to use the Q ability. The first power spike is Divine Sunderer, not because it gives you more damage and HP. It's a power spike due to its healing you get from your auto attacks after using an ability. 70% of your base AD, so by using Q and auto attacking, Nasus get a lot of sustain and can stick around in team fights for a longer period of time. The second item is going to be Deadman's Plate that works like this. When you don't attack, the item gains some stacks, increasing your movement speed up to 100 stacks, which is equal to 40 bonus movement speed. So it's just like a car that has to speed up before it reaches its maximum speed. So overall, running down enemies gets easier with this item. The last thing the enemy AD carry sees during the late game before he dies is... the raid boss will run around and delete anything that gets near him. From now on, you are playing this game on easy mode. You buy some tank items to make it even harder for the enemy to kill you, and with the additional resistances from Nasus ultimate. And with the lifesteal and the gargoyle shield, it's nearly impossible. So when you somehow manage to reach this stage of the game, it's GG. Playing these kind of brain-dead champions is the easiest way to get free wins. But jungle can be a tough role with a lot of tasks, so when you are looking for a brain-dead champion on an easy role, try Amumu support. A champion that has two tries to hit his hook and a point and click CC spell.